Just allow your body to land on your mat. Presence yourself to your breath. Breathe in, notice, be aware of how the lungs expand as you breathe in. And then exhale, draw your lower belly in and up towards your spine. Inhale, expand. Exhale, contract in. Keep your mind anchored into your breath. Life is like that. There's an ebb and flow that happens with life. And there's an ebb and a flow that happens with our breath. You just stay connected to the flow of your breath. And then extend your arms out. Press your palms down into your mat like an anchor. You connect yourself into your yoga mat, Earth. And then draw your upper arm bones into your shoulder sockets. So as your arms press down and reach away, your arm bones pull up and into your shoulders. Keep pressing down, spread your fingers wide. And then come up onto your knees and just lift your asana, big beautiful asana, up into the air. Downward facing dog. Take your feet hip width and your hands shoulder width. And for some of you, maybe even go a little bit wider. Take up space. Especially the people that wanted to hide behind the prop shelves, take up space. Get used to taking up space. If you have just one lifetime, do you want to spend it hiding? Some of you do, yes, I know. How's that working? You have the opportunity right now, right here, to take up and be in ownership for your space. Keep pressing your hands down. Ujjayi. And then lift up your heels. Bring your big toes together. Lift your heels up high. Yeah, like excellent, Scott. Get up high on the tippiest part of your toes. And then lift your two sitting bones towards the ceiling. Press your hands down. And then bend your knees nice and deep so that your chins are almost parallel to the floor. But then lift your sitting bones up at the same time. So shins dropping, but sitting bones lifting. Press your hands firmly down, and then take your thigh bones to the back wall. Create length and space. Laura, I already called people out for hiding behind, so you're going to have to come in here and get cozy with people. Laura, what's up with that? Bring your big toes together if they're not anymore. Take your right leg up. Open up your leg, open up your hip. Tap your neighbor to the left. Let them know that they're not alone, that you're here with them. Isn't it kind of crazy how we can be in a room full of 60 or 50 people and we feel like we're alone? Now look at your neighbor, make eye contact in the most awkward, weird way. Every plane I got on sat on the tarmac for an hour, and then got pulled back to the gate. And the last plane that I was on, I was in row 19, all of us ended up at the Delta Lounge together. And instead of just all of us hiding into our computers or our phones, we actually sat at a table together and had conversation. How unusual is it that we actually connect and see people and connect with people? We're so in the mode of hiding. Oh, people, why is your left leg not in the air? You cannot hide even in a group this big, I'm just telling you. Then people just see you hiding. Spread your toes. Tap your neighbor on this side if you haven't yet. You might have to get out of your comfort zone to tap them. All right, foot back down. Oh my God, people in their head, it's so hard. Walk your hands to the back of your mat. Ragdoll, feet hip width.
Go wide with your feet.
When Molly posted in the email, come to class on Saturday, Debbie's away, blah, blah, I was like, oh great, set the bar, Molly, for me. But it's actually good to do that for people in our lives, to hold the bar up high, to let people rise into their greatness. And each of you have the opportunity on your mat to show up as your greatest self in your greatness this morning. Set the bar up high for yourself. Walk your hands back out, down dog. Inhale, high plank. Exhale, down dog. High plank, inhale. Exhale, push back. Couple more times, keep going with your breath, and now. Move with your breath, but at the same time, move as a community. Go, breath in. Exhale back. Inhale. Press back. Two more times. Breath in. Press back. One more time. Breath in. Press back. Good work. Take a full breath in. Exhale. Empty. Bring your feet to your hands. Inhale. Halfway lift. Exhale. Fold. Halfway lift. Inhale. Exhale. Fold. Lengthen. Fold. Lengthen. Fold. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Rise. Arms up. Hands to your heart. Gaze at your fingertips. We'll take one Om breath in. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, fold, hands to your mat. Halfway lift, inhale. Hop back, lower, chaturanga. Upward facing, downward facing. Breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. One more. Empty, bring it forward. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Rise up. Fold forward. Lengthen. Take it back, lower. Up dog. Downward facing dog. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. One more. Empty it all out and then float. Breathe in and fold. Rise. Fold. Inhale. Chaturanga Dandasana. Up dog. Inhale. Down dog. One breath in. Empty. Bring it forward. Inhale. Exhale. Rise. Exhale forward. Inhale. Go back. Up dog. Downward facing dog. One breath in. Empty. You float. Keep flowing with your breath. One breath at a time. And move one breath at a time, but at the same time, I want you to move with the people around you. You move as one, but you also move as a community. So notice if you're stuck in your own personal preferences about how you do your sun salutations, and give that up for a greater whole. And if when I said that it made you angry or annoyed, then you're probably the person I'm speaking to. And that's okay. It's just the sound that we make with our breath when we pull it in from the back of our throat. It's not some mystical yoga secret. Breathe in. Exhale, empty, feet forward. Lengthen. Exhale, fold. Take chair pose again, this time hold it. Feet together, big toes together, heels about an inch apart. And then pull your shin bones towards the wall behind you. Pull your shin bones back. Pull your thigh bones back into your hip sockets. That's it. Lift all 10 of your toes off your mat. And then press down through the four corners of your feet. Drop your thigh bones towards your yoga mat. Now keep dropping from the pelvis down, earth, ground, and heart center. Lift up, lengthen. Take your gaze to the ceiling. Breathe in. Exhale, hands to your mat. Halfway lift, float back, chaturanga. Up dog, down dog, right foot forward, warrior one. Rise up, hold it. Now look at your front knee. Stack your front knee over your heel. Front thigh parallel to the floor. Go longer, Adam. Poor Adam. Who feels sorry for Adam? It's very disempowering to feel sorry for other people. Now drop into the pose. Look at your neighbor. Now tell them if they're not parallel to the floor. Mason, please hold Adam accountable to go deeper. Now from your pit of your belly, reach up. Like from the core, you want to dig deep, people. Dig deep to live fully. Drop deeper, child of mine. Okay, gaze up, breathe in. Exhale, hands to the mat, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Other side, left foot forward. Now just do it. Don't wait for your neighbor to have to tell you. Breathe. Now look at your neighbor and let them know that your thigh is not parallel to the floor, Adam.
I miss you too, Debbie.
Okay. Oh, Mimi, that's it. Press the outer edge of your back foot into the mat. You got this, girlfriend. Earth. Press down into the earth, and then you draw the energy up. Arms up. That's it. Oh, reach beyond what you think is possible. Reach for the ceiling tiles behind you, and at the same time, drop deeper into your front leg. You got this. Gaze up, girlfriend. Go. Look at the ceiling, reach for it, and then hands down. Up dog, downward facing dog. How many of you were just waiting for that pose to be over? You start dealing with things as they are and as they aren't. Breathe in. Exhale, empty your breath out, and then float. Inhale, lengthen, and fold. Chair pose again. Own it this time. Own it. Like you are king or queen of your chair. All 10 toes off the floor. Thigh bones, core is the wall behind you. And if you're plugging your thigh bones into your hip sockets, you keep drawing back. That's it. And then deeper, 3 inches, guys. See if you can get your thighs parallel to the floor here. That's it, Carrie. Heart center higher. Straighten your arms.
Straighten your arms.
Okay, fold. Halfway lift. Chaturanga. Upward. Downward. Right foot forward. One breath to rise. Breathe in, rise up. Exhale, flow, chaturanga. Oh, the flow you've been waiting for. Inhale. Exhale, left side, step forward, rise. And then exhale, take it down. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. And out. One more. Empty and float. Inhale. Exhale. Chair pose. One breath. Fold. Inhale. Exhale. Breathe in. Exhale, down dog. Right foot forward. One breath to rise. Exhale, lower. Inhale. Exhale, left side, step forward, rise. Exhale, lower. Breathe in. Down dog. 3 breaths here. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Breathe in. Exhale, empty. You float. Inhale. Exhale, chair, fold, inhale, chaturanga, up dog, down dog, right side, warrior one, chaturanga. Inhale. Exhale. Left side. Rise. And lower. Inhale. Exhale. Three breaths, and then you're going to flow through Sun Bees together as a group with your breath. After your third breath, you'll move, and neighbors, be with your neighbors. Go. See what happens, what's possible when you actually get in sync with the people around you. And if you've lost pacing with your neighbors, then see if you can tune back in together. You stay connected to your breath, you stay connected to self, and at the same time, you stay connected to the people around you. Notice your thoughts and that they are not you. So even if you're having thoughts of misery, they're not you. They're just your thoughts. If you can observe it, it's not you. When you complete your current Sun Bee, so that would be your left side of Warrior Two, then you'll hold Down Dog. Good morning, Matt. I didn't say hi to you today. And then when you're done, you can do Child Pose, Down Dog, or Headstand. You choose. And even though you're choosing, some of you are choosing beverage break, that's okay too. You choose, but you still breathe as a community. So even though at this point you choose your own path, you choose it in a way that's in alignment with the people around you. A global awareness. Take five breaths wherever you are. And then after your fifth breath, Down Dog, not Child Pose. Set your hands up wide. Connect to your breath, set your drishti, your gaze with intention. Pull your weight back into your heels. Weight back into your heels, lift and spread all 10 of your toes, all 10 of them. Keep pulling back into your thighs. Thigh bones parallel to the floor. Now if your head said no, stop listening to your head. thigh bones parallel to the floor. Pull back even deeper, even deeper. Lift the pit of the belly. That's it, Nancy Arden. Okay, now let your knees begin to open wide and then sit your asana down, boat pose. Without a crinkle on your lip. Hug your knees into your chest. Everybody hug your knees into your chest. Lift your heels to knee height. Lift the pit of your belly in. Lift your heart towards the ceiling. That's it, Megan. Now keep pulling in tight. Pull in tight. Spread your toes and release your arms straight out. Set your drishti. Set it. Spread your toes. Wave your toes up. Inhale, low boat. Exhale, high. Lift up. Inhale, low. Exhale, high. Good. Three more. Exhale, lift. Two more. Lift. One more. Lift. Full boat pose. Full expression. Full expression. Breathe. Open your belly in. That's it. Lift your heart center even higher. Pull your sacrum from it. Rock back and then rock forward. Chair pose. Now you like chair pose. Pull your weight back into the heels. Ground yourself. You want to live in the present moment, in the weight of your heels, thigh bones down, mat. Full breath in. Exhale, fold forward. Breathe in, lengthen. Hop back, lower, chaturanga. Up dog. Exhale, down dog. Inhale, lift your right leg up and flip your dog open all the way. Oh, heels, do wheel. Non-heels, do wheel. Keep breathing. That's it. You go, Deb. For three, lift your hips higher. Two and one. Release side plank. Right hand down. Left arm up. Yeah, now empower yourself. Take your top leg up. Press your bottom foot down into the earth. Get the rebound effect. Draw the pit of the belly in and lift your top leg. That's it. Externally lift. Rotate your top leg. Momentum. Good. Turn your heart open. Higher, Scott, you got this. Chaturanga. Inhale up and then push back. Left leg up and over. Flip over. Take your neighbor with you. People don't want to be left behind or left out.
That's okay.
That's the worst feeling when you feel left out. So you be inclusive. You include everyone. That's it, Joe Walter. Reach for the front of the room. Tap that front wall. Your hand is on the floor. Tap the front wall. That's it, Jody. Even higher. Keep lifting hips higher. Unflip side plank. Heels to the left. Michael, it makes me so happy to see you in the front row. Out of your comfort zone. Externally rotate your top leg so your toes point to the ceiling. That's it. Keep turning your hips. Yes, it does. It doesn't do that, and yet it does. See, that's the magic of yoga. When you think things are impossible, yoga shows you that they are. Oh, lift higher. Yes, keep rotating. Rotate. Yeah, that's it. Pull your tailbone in. What's your first name?
Joe.
Joe. Hi, Joe. Welcome. Chaturanga. Up dog. Exhale, down dog. Stop living in the world of can'ts and don'ts and start living in the world of possibility. Inhale, lift your right leg up. Exhale, knee to chest, press it, lunge. Laura, back in the game. Press lunge. Now again, front thigh parallel to your yoga mat. Unless you're pregnant or something, see what I said. Now pull your front leg forward. That's it. Now press your back thigh towards the ceiling. Lift up the pit of the belly. Take it up. Reach up. Go back. Knees up. Full breath in. Take all that length. Twist to the right. Elbow to the outside of your thigh. If you're pregnant, hand on the inside of your front foot. And then twist your chest open. Yeah, you can open up your arms. Turn your gaze now. That's it. Keep opening. Smile from the inside. The practice of contentment. Contentment. Straighten your back leg, Hannah. Straighten it. That's it. Breathe in. Look down, Rise Warrior 2. Breathe into it, drop. Thigh bones connected to the earth. Ujjayi. Keep breathing. I loved in the movie Avatar how all the roots connected all the different trees. It's like, get that sense from your pose right now. You're all connected to the same piece of concrete. Breathe down into it. Feel the power of everybody's breath in the room. Inhale, we climb. Extend this side angle. Tap arm over your ear. You got this, Rob. Now twist your chest open. Twist your chest open. Keep breathing. Pull your tailbone in. Tailbone in even more. Pull it under. That's it. Both shoulders back. Take one more breath. And then take it down. Chaturanga. Full breath in, up dog. That's it, Tanya. And then push back, down dog. Take a breath in and just let it out. Left leg up, breathe in. Step forward, press it on, rise. Rise from the earth to the ceiling. Straighten your back leg. Lift your back heel off your yoga mat. Back heel up as high as you can. Stack your heel over the mound of your foot. Ujjayi. Adam, it's your turn to tell Mason to go longer. Front thigh parallel to the floor. That's it. Belly in and up. And then twist. Now, firm your back thigh up. Firm the back thigh up and twist yourself into the pose. Keep twisting. One more breath in. Look down and rise, Warrior 2. Ooh, Becky's going to deliver a baby.
Yay!
That's so exciting. New birth, new breath. New life, breathe new life into this pose. And breathe it in, sit deeper. And then recline. Take it forward, extended side angle. Extend. Oh, bring breath in, invite your breath in. Stay with it. Grow from the outer waist, like through the back heel, and then from the outer waist to the top arm. Grow. Take one more breath in. Exhale, hands down. Step back, you lower. Up, we're facing. Downward facing. And breathe in, full breath. Exhale, empty, float your feet forward. Inhale, lengthen, and fold. Chair pose. Your resting pose, breathe. Pull your weight back into your heels. Thigh bones parallel to the floor. Even if you have a story about why your thighs don't do that, give up your story and just do it. Stick your butt back even more, Jennifer Mars. Weight back even more. Into your heels. Into your heels. That's it. Keep taking the weight back as if you feel like you're going to fall, but you don't. Even deeper. More breath. Invite it in. Thigh bones deeper. Oh, don't give up on yourself. Two more breaths. One more breath. Navasana, boat pose. Navasana is just Utkatasana on your butt. Breathe, spread your toes. Knees into your chest, lift up from your heart. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Don't just breathe for yourself, breathe for everyone around you. Inhale, low boat. exhale high. You got this. Inhale low. Exhale high. Two more. Lift. One more. And lift. Full boat. Set your sails high. That's it. Set your heart. Set your gaze. Rock back and then rock up. Chair pose. Now check in with your thoughts. Check in with your mental state right now. Some of you, your face is saying I'm miserable. Check in with that. If that's what you want to be, then you, that's great. You be it. If not, choose something different for yourself right now. And take ego on the right side. Right leg over, right arm under. Ujjayi. Lift your elbows up. Draw your upper arm bones back into your shoulder socket. See if you can get your elbows all the way up at your shoulder height. That's it. Two more breaths. One more breath. Release the other side. Keep your drishti set between your poses. The transition between your poses should be like a dance. Not like you've stepped out of the building. Ujjayi, elbow shoulder height. Keep lifting your elbows higher. Weight back more into your standing heel. That's it, Carrie. Nice, Francis. Stay present. One more breath here. And then keep your drishti set. Go to the other side. Don't lose your gaze. Don't lose it. Hold it steady. Discipline. Oh, you lost your gaze. Other side. Right leg over, right arm under. It's like that. How quickly we lose focus. We get distracted by things that are going on around us. We start living in reaction to things instead of being at cause, seeing what is the end goal. What is the goal that you want to create? And you stay focused on that goal. And it doesn't matter what's happening around you. You just ignore it. Breathe. Switch sides. Drishti set. Not ignore in a way like there's shit that's going on that you got to deal with, but you don't let it take you out from accomplishing what you have your vision set to accomplish. Now everybody set your drishti right now with power. You're all looking at the same wall, a shared horizon. Keep your drishti, keep your gaze, and stand in Tadasana. Keep your drishti set. Right leg up, grab your knee or your toe. Stay in line with your line. Notice if you stepped out. You want to be in alignment with the people around you. Being in alignment doesn't mean necessarily being in agreement, but you're in alignment. You have a shared drishti. Now open your leg out to the right. Take your gaze over to the left. Again, shared horizon, shared drishti as we all look to the left. Check back in with your breath. Invite the breath back in. One more breath here. Now shift your drishti back to the front wall. Bring your leg center, arms to the ceiling. Lift your leg as high as you can. Hold it up. And then bend the knee, take your leg back. Airplane pose. Again, share drishti. You set your drishti. Ujjayi. Set your gaze down at your mat, and then reach your left hand to the floor to a block. It's half, what do we call this? Half moon. You got this. Nice. Oh, lift your leg even higher. Even higher, Stephen. Stephen, I'm so happy you came.
That makes one of us.
I bet Marla's happy, too. That would make two. Catch your back foot. Catch it. Use your block, it'll make you happier. Now bend your back leg, grab your back foot. Reach, bend this leg, bend it. Your foot's back there somewhere. Even if you can't see it, it's back there. It's just like the other half of the moon. And then slowly, mindfully, standing forward bend. Feet hip width apart, grab your big toes. Now pull yourself, commit to the forward bend, commit. Lift your sitting bones up as you press your heel bones down. Lift your kneecaps up, kneecaps up. Drop your head. And then inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold feet together. Press your feet down, rise up, arms to the ceiling. Hands to your hips. Catch your left leg and set your joystick. Ujjayi. Again, now shared horizon, shared horizon. We all set our drishti on the same horizon. Open your leg out to the left and then shift your gaze to the right. Drop your outer left hip so your hips are level. If your neighbor's there and you choose to support them, that's great. If you choose not to, that's great too. Now bring your gaze forward, set the drishti, keep the drishti, stay focused. Keep the drishti, leg out in front of you, arms up, lift as high as you can. Higher than you think you can. And then take it back, airplane pose. Press back, press back. Squeeze your shoulder blades together, that's it. Wake your hands up, wake your fingers up, spread your fingers wide, nice Maggie. Palms facing the floor. Shift your drishti to the floor, half moon. Now anchor through the big toe mound of your standing foot. Anchor down and open up your hip. If you fell out, you go back in. We all fall sometimes. Lift your leg back even higher, you got this. Now catch your back foot. Catch it, catch it. Press down through your big toe mound. Now lift up away from the floor. Don't drop into it. Lift up away from it. Steven, you're so close. You're like 3 or 4 inches. One more breath. Two more breaths. Okay, look down and right. Oh no, fold forward. Feet hip width. Oh, okay. Hands under your feet. Padmasana. Now again, press down through your heels and take your sitting bones towards the ceiling. Feel the power, the rebound power, as you press down to lift your butt up. Lift your kneecaps up, suck them up. Drop your head completely. No wrinkles at the back of the neck, or they're always getting Botox in the back of the neck. More breaths. And one. Inhale, lengthen, look forward. Exhale, bring your feet together and fold. Press down to rise up all the way. Hands to your heart. Right side dancer. Set your joystick. Breathe yourself into it. Now dance with the people around you. You know what I mean? Like, you know sometimes there's that crazy person on a dance, like Elaine from Seinfeld, doing her own crazy thing? Be in dancer pose with everyone. Your own self-expression, and at the same time, you're dancing as a whole. Take 3 more breaths here. And then rise up, do the other side. Other side, drishti set, don't give up. Get out of your mental thoughts, they're taking you out. You wanna start creating distinction between your thoughts and the present moment. Yeah, breathe louder than your thoughts, that's it, Adam. You got this. And then inhale, rise. Dancer pose again. Other side. First side. You got this. Soften your mouth and your tongue. Wherever we go, there we are. And then rise up, left side. Be happy about it. It's happening anyway. Or you could be miserable, I don't care. That's it. Nice. Drishti set. Drishti set. Tongues in your mouth. Experience the best of yourself in this moment. Experience the best of humanity in this moment. You be the best of humanity. And then inhale, rise. Right side tree. Right side tree. Oh, give up your delay tactics, towel wiping off people. That's the best one, Adam said. What are your delay tactics? Wiping off your sweat, what else? I need a drink. I have to go pee. Full expression. As soon as you start thinking, you take yourself out. I used to get up and walk every day with a friend of mine. And man, the mornings that we'd be like, are we walking, were the mornings that we always just took ourselves out instead of just being led to do it. Other side. The mind likes to choose the easy route. Breathe. You don't choose the easy route. You choose the path that will get you the results that you want. Extend your arms long and straight. Squeeze your arms into your ears like earmuffs. Hug them in, hug them in. And then mindfully release. Both feet on the floor. Tadasana. Inhale, reach your arms up. Exhale, fold. I wish this class was 90 minutes. Halfway lift, hop back and lower. Let's do it. All right, up dog. I won't. I respect your time. Exhale, down dog. Molly's like, you better. All right, Molly. Right side triangle, go. Get long in your pose. Longer, Bonnie, by about 12 inches, triangle pose. Even longer, Bonnie. Even longer, Joe. Triangle, triangle. Press your bottom hand into the floor or into a block and then twist your chest open. Take one full breath in. Exhale, look down, inhale to rise. Turn to face the windows, hands to your hips, feet parallel. Lengthen on your in-breath. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, halfway lift. Lengthen your spine. And then fold tight. Watch your neighbor tiny. And then walk your hands to the front of your mat, pyramid pose, fold over your front leg. If the floor is far away, then start grabbing blocks for your practice from now on. Go longer, Annalie. Now lengthen, inhale, take your gaze forward, and then twisting triangle. Lift your right arm up. That's it. Twist, press into my hand, child. Press, now turn your heart open, turn open, gaze open, gaze to the ceiling. That's it, Jennifer Mars, even higher with your gaze. Drishti to the ceiling for everyone, all twisted triangles. Nice, Barrett. And then exhale, look down, Chaturanga Dandasana. Up, dog. Down, dog. Left left side triangle. Pretty awesome, huh, Scott?
Yeah.
You dry. Hug your belly. Use your belly. Pour in. Bring your hands to the outside of your shin. Yeah, that's it. Now press down through the big toe mound. And then draw the energy up from the earth. Draw it up. One more breath in. And then look down. Rise. Inhale. Lift all the way. Turn to face the props. Hands to your hips. Turn to look to the hiding spot over here. And then inhale, spread your arms. Hands behind your back and close your fingers. Shoulder blades together, breathe in. Fold forward, turn your toes slightly in. Lift your hands away from your butt. You might hit your neighbor's butt. Worst things have happened, I'm sure. It's really great to start getting clear in your life about things that are actually big deals and things that aren't. Like, some people were freaking out yesterday when they pulled us off our plane. And it happened to me twice. And some people were freaking out. And I was like, oh, I'd rather be taken off the plane than falling out of the sky. Like, what's the real big deal? Release your hands to the floor. Inhale, lengthen. Hands to your hips, side. Mr. Neighbor, you know what I mean. And then pyramid pose to the front of your mat. Shift your feet and then fold. Keep your pose long. Pull your left hip towards the wall behind you. And your right hip forward. Press your shoulder blades together if your hands are behind your back. Palms together, Jennifer, yes. And then exhale, release your hands. Set your gaze forward, lift your heart center, and then twist. Breathe, you got this. If your eyes are shut, open them. And be in the room, not in your head thinking. Being out here with people, as opposed to torturing yourself inside the head. One more breath in, and then exhale, look down, sit back, chaturanga, light on, inner light bright. Exhale, down dog. High plank. Low plank. No plank. Bring your hands behind your back, interlace your fingers, and then lift yourself up into locust pose. Lift up, squeeze your shoulder blades together, hands behind your back. That's it, Carrie, lift yourself. Set your drishti. Drishti set. Where's your attention on? Start seeing what your attention is on. Put it on your gaze and on your breath. Lift even higher, Noelle. You got this. Yes. And then exhale, release. You know, sometimes we just need somebody to see us for us to step into our greatness. You want to know you are seen. Lift up again. Grab your ankles this time. Dhanurasana. Bow pose. Press your feet back towards the wall behind you. Spread your toes. Spread them. Oh, lift up even higher. See if you can get to the top of your thighs. All the way to the top of your thighs. Keep lifting. Exhale, lower. Ah. Oh, it's so good. Up dog. Up dog. Sit down, dog. Right side pigeon. Bring your foot as far forward as you can, and then fold forward over your front leg. You need to modify. drop your head. Drop it. And along with dropping your head, drop all your thinking and just set your intention on your breath. Even here, breathe louder than your thoughts. Take 3 full breaths. After your 3rd breath, switch sides. Inner space out. The stories you're attached to, give them up. Your self-limiting thoughts and beliefs, give them up. Your non-self-serving habits, like looking at your iWatch during practice, give it up. Give yourself the gift of just being here, in this moment. Down dog. And then hop to a seated pose. Lay down, happy baby. Happy baby. Yeah. Rock a little bit from side to side. Feel the floor beneath you. Gravity has always got your back. Now send your legs out. Grab your neighbor's foot. Even if you're like, no, I don't want to. Spread your legs and grab your neighbor's This past week, because in Utah, the first place that I ever did a program with Baron, and during that week, he said, because it's just something that he says, death is coming to a body near you soon. Think about that. And it was funny because he said it again this week. And I think I was like almost exactly in the same spot in the room. But for me, it was a reminder that we really do just have this lifetime that we know of. And are you living your life in I can't and I don't? Or are you living your life in the world of possibility? When you get out of your own way, and if you could give up what's in your way, what would be possible for you? What would you give up? And then what would be possible? Mindfully bend your knees and place your feet flat on the mat. Just pause here. Pause. And roll to your right. Rest your head on your right arm. Unless you're pregnant, you can roll left. Rise up I don't really know what's going on here. I'm so sorry. We'll end with a C of three ohms. Breath in. That shines in each and every one of us. Together we say, Namaste. Namaste. I mean, look at this space here and all these people, and they've all come for you and the community that you've built. You are yoga. You embody yoga at your core every day. And I think I speak for everyone in the room when I say that we love you. And on behalf of my team, will you be our ambassador? But be with all of you in a practice that is empowering and inspiring and create space for all of us. And so I'm so grateful. I'm so grateful to Marlo, who has been a dear friend and support of mine for so many years. And the Lululemon team is amazing. I actually told her and Michaela recently, I'm like, the team you guys have created is so amazing. So I'm so inspired by all you guys. I love coming in the store and being with you. And I love teaching yoga. And so I'm so grateful that you guys actually show up for my classes and show up for my team. I mean, my team is so great, and I just am so grateful. So thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you.